They say the American market is a gold mine for European entrepreneurs, but how do you stand out in the competitive landscape? I'm Christina Robofe-Broadus, the American Market Alchemist, and I believe that anyone can write their U.S. success story to amplify their influence and scale their impact beyond the borders of their home market. In this podcast, you'll hear inspiring stories and practical advice from American market experts and European entrepreneurs who are making an impact in the U.S. Tune in each week for a dose of motivation and tactical tips to build your influence and visibility in the world's largest market so you stand out, attract more clients, and turn your European business into American gold. Now, let's dive in. If you're staying quiet about your skills, you're making a big mistake. And I'm going to show you how speaking up will get the clients that you deserve. Now, let's face it, self-promotion can feel uncomfortable, especially if you're coming from a more European business culture where modesty and self-depreciation is really the norm. But in the US, things work differently. Here, confidence equals competence. And if you're not putting yourself out there, you're missing opportunities to grow your business and to connect with the right clients. So today, we'll dive into how you can promote yourself to get American clients, to build up your personal brand with confidence in the American market without feeling like you're boasting too much. And by the end, you'll walk away from this episode with actionable tips to step into the spotlight confidently. Now, before we get into all of that, I want to invite you to my next Transatlantic Entrepreneur Workshop. It's free. It's on October 19th. It's online. So no matter where you are, you can join us. But even more important, we're going to break down the barriers that are holding you back today from getting the recognition that you deserve with those American clients that you want. So the link to save your spot is down below this episode. Now, let's get into the things that are maybe preventing you from speaking up as much as you should be in order to get those American clients. The first reason is perhaps a cultural disconnect, but where promoting yourself just feels awkward based on the culture that you grew up in. One of the biggest reasons that European entrepreneurs specifically struggle with self-promotion in the US is because of this deep cultural difference. In many European countries, based on my experience of living here for 20 years, subtlety is valued, and being overly vocal about your accomplishments can feel almost distasteful, like you're bragging, like you're trying to say, hey, look at me, when that is really not the culture. But in the US, if you don't speak up about your achievements, you risk being overlooked. Americans expect confidence and clarity. They want to know immediately what you can do for them. You know, we think of John F. Kennedy in his famous speech, and he said, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. We just want to know what's in it for me. And if you don't convey that up front, they might assume that you're not capable or highly skilled or just able to get the solution that you say you can get them. Think of, for example, a networking event where you only casually mention your achievements or you downplay them. An example, a real life example from a client I worked with. We were talking before we started working together, and I said, and he said, you know, I need to work on my communication skills for interviews. And I said, okay, job interviews. And he said, no, it's more interviews with a journalist and things like that. And I said, oh, that's interesting. I said, well, you know, what's the context? Why are you being interviewed by these journalists? And he said, well, I do swimming, I do free diving, and I've won like 5 championships. I've got 3 world records. I'm the youngest person with this world record. And I was like, why didn't you tell me that up front? You know, don't be so modest about it. And that's a true story. So we worked on, part of what we worked on was, how do we talk about those achievements? Now, you don't have to be the youngest world record holder for freediving or anything like that, but you definitely want to play up your accomplishments. And yes, humility is also a value, but knowing that you're good at what you do and not being afraid to share that with others is something that is going to attract clients to you. Like I said, Americans are used to clear, confident communication. We have that expression, fake it till you make it, which you've probably heard, but they want to know that you can deliver and how fast you can do it. So the shift in mindset that you need to take away here is to embrace being clear and upfront and confident about your accomplishments. Use that as a tool for building trust, not seeing it as arrogance. Remember, confidence is seen as competence in the US. Now, the second thing that may be holding you back from getting the American clients that you would like to have is this aversion or this fear, or just you don't like self-promotion. The first thing that I hear a lot about is the imposter syndrome. And that is a super common obstacle. I mean, even for people in their native language. I think if you're an entrepreneur, you probably feel this at some point in your life. I know I feel this all the time. And I have to do a lot of work with myself and with my coach to remind myself that, you know, that's all in my head. Because you might be thinking, especially if you are based in Europe and you're trying to get American clients, you might be thinking, why would they choose me? Or, you know, what if they find out that I'm not as good as I say I am or I think I am? And this feeling is completely normal. And I mean, it's even more amplified when you're going into a new market with a different culture, with a different language, and you have competitors, you have American competitors doing the same thing that you do. So if you're feeling that imposter syndrome, just know that it is normal, but it shouldn't stop you from going out there and getting the recognition that you deserve, because your expertise and your experience are valuable. And your American clients, they want to know what you can do for them, not what you can't do or what you think you can't do. Another big difficulty that a lot of people face is this fear of rejection. And again, this is something I think that every entrepreneur probably feels. I can't speak for everybody, but I know I do. I feel it this way. Fear of rejection. It's, you know, what if you contact somebody and you feel like, you know, I don't know the codes. I'm not sure exactly what I should say. What if I offend them? What if I don't hear anything back? What if they send me a nasty message in response? In reality, that's probably not going to happen. Especially Americans tend to be polite. Worst comes to worst, they'll ignore you or they'll say, yeah, hey, awesome, great. And then it never goes any further. So, I mean, that can be discouraging feeling that way. But here's the reality. Rejection happens in every market, and no matter the language, the culture, whatever, it is part of being an entrepreneur. So the key is to just keep going. And the more that you promote yourself, the better your chances of connecting with those clients, the right clients, and also maybe the more comfortable you'll get with it also. You know, you got to practice it to get comfortable with it. Now, another thing that tends to hold back some of the clients that I've been working with. This is one that comes up very often. It is the fear of their accent Or the fear of being perceived as a small, insignificant player in the big American market. Now, the truth is, for the accent, American clients probably care less about your accent than you do. If they can understand you, they care more about what you can deliver and if they can trust you. Now, yes, accent bias is a real thing. I can talk about that in another video and how you can overcome it, but just know that they're probably less concerned with your accent than you are. And in fact, your international identity and experience can be a strength if you position it as a strength, if you own it, if you make it a part of who you are. Now, it doesn't have to be your entire brand identity, but just being authentic, to be honest, that is a way that you can make your foreignness a positive thing when you're promoting yourself. So just a takeaway is that you don't need to change who you are. You just need to shift your mindset from feeling like an outsider to recognizing that your skills and your difference are valuable. And that's true no matter the market. Now, another thing is reframing self-promotion. Think of it as serving, not selling. Now, this is really a critical mindset shift. Promoting yourself isn't about selling. It's not about persuading someone to buy your thing when they don't need it. It can be, but that's like used car salesman, snake oil. We don't want to be that kind of salesperson. Selling, it's about serving. And when you approach self-promotion from a place of service, of I have this expertise, I know how to solve these problems, and I know that there are people out there with those problems, then for you, it becomes a much easier, a much more comfortable process. And you're not bragging by talking about what you do. You're helping others by showing them how you can solve their problems. And one way that you can do this is, you know, telling your story, your real story. Well, I call your immigrant story, even if you're coming into the U.S. We Americans, we love immigrant stories. And when they hear your journey and why you want to come and do business in the U.S., then they're going to connect with you on a human level, especially given the history of Americans, most of whom are, you know, descendants of immigrants. And so they can understand that. So then they're not just buying a service, they're building a relationship with someone that they trust. So takeaway is framing self-promotion as sharing how you can help others, as sharing your experience, your expertise, your wisdom. And again, not just boasting, but putting yourself out there because you know that out there, there are people that need you and you are allowing them to find you. It becomes about offering solutions. And that is what you want your American clients to see. Now, a couple of actionable tips for promoting yourself effectively here. The first thing is going to be network, 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 and leverage your existing network. Now, you don't need to start from scratch. Whether you have contacts here in Europe or in the US, you probably already have some foundation to build on. Reach out to those people that are already in your network. Ask for introductions, ask for referrals, tell them what you do. Just ask them, hey, can you keep your ears open in case you hear of someone who needs my help? In the US, networking is huge, and people are often more willing to help you connect than you might think. So don't hesitate to ask for that introduction or to just ask if they know somebody that they can introduce you or refer you to. Consistency is key. I say this all the time. Consistency is key. Yes, you need to be visible. You need to show up regularly. For example, on LinkedIn, posting regularly, showing up in the comments of your target market, engaging with the audience on your posts, sharing success stories, posting content that demonstrates your expertise, that gives you a lot of things to share already on LinkedIn. But the more consistently you show up, the more trust you'll build. And about the accent bias, if you can do videos or podcasts in English, that helps people to get used to your accent. So it just becomes part of who you are. And they already know and come to trust you despite that foreign accent. Now, the more you do that, the more trust you'll build. And yes, building up your personal brand takes time, but the more you stay visible, the more opportunities will come your way. So if you're feeling unsure about promoting yourself online, start by posting one success story or one tip related to your industry, and just do that once per week. You don't have to flood people with content or post every day or twice a day or more, but start consistently, even if that is just once per week. Now, I want to just help you to, let go of this fear, embrace this confidence, start promoting yourself with clarity, boldness. Don't be afraid to put yourself out there. Start doing it consistently. The right clients will connect with you. And that is how you are going to grow your business with American clients one step at a time. Now, if you found this episode useful, make sure that you subscribe for more tips on building your personal brand, attracting American clients, getting the word out about what you're doing and all the great ways that you're helping your target audience and those American clients. And I just want to say thank you for coming to the end of this episode. And remember, be bold, stand out, and let's show the world what you're all about. I'll see you next time.
Thanks for listening to the American Market Alchemist podcast. If you're ready to amplify your influence and scale your impact in the U.S. market, become a member of my newsletter community. You'll get weekly tips on LinkedIn strategy, personal branding, and digital marketing to write your U.S. success story. The link to get the newsletter is in the show notes. I'm Christina Robafe-Broadus, and I'll talk to you next time.